Well, amphibians are wonderful for their own sake, if you happen to love frogs and salamanders and tadpoles. They're also really important parts of the ecosystem.
The biggest problem for amphibians in our area is lack of habitat.
In our region, the woods typically evolved with a lot of sunlight reaching the ground. And what has happened over time is that invasive species have come in and crowded out the woods, made them dense and dark so that nothing can grow on the ground. And that's not good habitat for amphibians or other animals because they need to eat the bugs that are eating those plants. So the more different kinds of plants we have growing on the ground, the more habitats for amphibians and other animals.
We're out at one of our amphibian habitat restoration sites where we have groups come out to try and restore this area to its native condition.
I'm a volunteer site steward with the Forest Preserve District of Cook County, and this particular site is part of our partnership with the Shed Aquarium. By improving the habitat here by doing restoration, we're giving the amphibians their home, their food, and the place where they can reproduce. We're giving them everything that they need in order to survive.
This work goes on all four seasons and ongoing for many years in a row.
And it's important to come here year-round because there's certain opportunities that you can only take advantage of at certain times of the year.
What we were doing today was really stage one of restoration, and that's getting the woody invasives out.
They're making sunlight for the plants to grow so the insects can eat the plants and the frogs can eat the insects.
But also in the fall, all of the wildflowers and grasses have their seeds ripening. So we go into healthy areas and we collect those seeds. Then we spread them in the places that we had just cleared of buckthorn the previous winter. Otherwise, we would just be leaving bare ground with nothing to take its place.
Conservation doesn't occur at any particular temperature. You just do it when it's right, and winter just happens to be that time when we need to get a handle on the buckthorn and the honeysuckle.
It's a good opportunity to come out here and cut them down now. I mean, you really don't have the foliage and leaves in the way. When we first started here, it was fully covered. Everything behind me was just full of stuff, and we actually made a huge impact today. Go winter!
I especially love the spring because after the cold winter, you come out and all the flowers are blooming.
Springtime is when the frogs and salamanders get active, and we listen to their calls, we turn over logs and look for the animals. We count how many are here and monitor their progress. Summer is a great time to come out because it's just beautiful.
You get to see all these plants coming up that weren't there the year before because there was too much shade. It's a direct result of the work that we're doing.
These are all different ryegrasses. We're seeing the green dragon, which is very rarely seen, and the baby oaks coming up is very encouraging.
Coming out year after year and season after season, you get to see the changes. You get to see the sun coming back down to the ground level. You get to see the plants starting to come back out again, and then you get to see the animals come out and utilize the habitat. It's just awesome.
The Forest Preserves has a goal of restoring approximately 30,000 acres to really high quality condition within the next couple of decades.
It's a tough job, and there's a lot of area for us to restore. And there's no way that we can do it on our own. So the volunteers really make this program work.
It's actually pretty fun when you think of it.
It's worth getting bitten by bugs to help.
I love physical labor and I love helping the environment, so it's the best of both worlds for me.
I think I will probably be exhausted from all the work, cutting down bigger trees. It hurts your muscle a lot.
A few hours a day can make a real impact in conservation, and I think that you have 15 students that didn't realize what an impact they could make. It's wonderful that Shed is offering that opportunity.
There are 90 steward sites in the Forest Preserve districts, and there's a volunteer work day every weekend and some during the week.
There's so much work that needs to be done here, and I hope that this just continues to grow.
She found this on Facebook and then texted me about it, and here I am. I feel like I could do that to someone else and they can do that for someone else.
The great thing is that we're not only preserving habitat for amphibians, but we're preserving habitat for everything else too. So what we're doing is making the woods healthier. It's healthier for plants and all of the animals that use it, and for people.